Venkata Ganesh, Associated Professor of Marine Engineering Department, Amet University, situated in Kanathur. Today I will be taking in the subject of watchkeeping, the topic of work rest hour. The requirement of work rest hours has initiated by the ILO and STCW and OPA 90. Earlier days, the work rest hour is not a requirement because the people who are working on board with the heavy physical labor. As the technology improves, the people started having the fatigue and depression, everything. So the STCW, the IMO has come up with the STCW this thing, convention. And they have introduced the work rest hour. In the same time, this ILO also started with the work rest hour. And OPA 90 of US government has got the same work rest hour. So let us see what work rest hour says. This work rest hour on board. The rest hour, according to STCW, a minimum of 10 hours rest at any 24 hours point of period, 77 hours of work in any 7-day period. The hours of rest may be divided into two, a minimum of 6 hours at a stretch, and now in the interval of two intervals, the gap between two intervals should not exceed more than 14 hours. This ILO, they formed the Maritime Labor Convention, and in that the work hours of the ship members is detailed below. A number of ship working hours should be 8 hours a day under normal circumstances, with 1 day in a week as a rest day. A maximum of 14 hours a day, 14 hours in any 24 hours period. Maximum of 72 hours in any 7-day period, provided minimum of 10 hours rest in any 24 hours period. A minimum of 10 hours in any 24 hours period, a minimum of 77 hours of rest in any 7-day period. The hours of rest can be divided into maximum of 2 periods, one of which should be of 6 hours, and two such consecutive periods should not be separated by more than 14 hours. A seafarer must be granted a compensatory rest period in case he or she is required to be called during the rest hour. Operation like lifeboat drill, fire drill, and drills prescribed by the national laws and regulation should be conducted in a manner to ensure minimum disruption of period. Of course, this lifeboat drill and firefighting drill, normally it will not be counted as a working period. Number of ship working hours and hours of rest of all crew member must be displayed in a place easy accessibility for the purpose of informing the seafarer due time. A log recording number of hours of work and rest for the every crew member should be maintained at all times, and a copy of this work rest hour should be given to the individual seafarer also. However, an exception can be made to all above mentioned class. In case if master feels that it is necessary the service of the required seafarer to maintain the safety of the ship, especially in the case of emergencies, master can suspend the schedule of work and hours of rest in situation of vessel distress and require seafarer to perform necessary duties until normal conditions are restored. On return to normal condition, seafarer involved in work during the period of distress should be granted rest period to prevent buildup of fatigue. Deck and engineer officer along with the apprentice and cadets may also require to work in excess of above mentioned limit, all which shall be considered as overtime. For each hour of overtime work, the officer would be entitled for the compensatory hours of rest and a overtime remuneration. For trainees and cadets, it should be noted that all above mentioned provision shall vary for the seafarer, trainees and cadets. For all such crew member, how many hours to work on ship shall be governed by the separate set of rules, which says working hours on ship should not exceed 8 hours per day and 49 hours per week. Overtime of this above limits is allowed only under unavoidable circumstances and under no condition can be allowed on regular basis. Sufficient time shall be provided for the purpose of meal, with at least an hour for the main meal of the day. A 15 minutes rest period shall be allowed after every 2 hours period of 2 hours continuous work. Except in the above mentioned previous provisions can be made if there is a hinder of effective training. Schedule or post problem with watch keeping duties, especially on deck and engine and catering department. Any exception made shall be due to the recorded and compensated. Young seafarer by order of master of the ship may be needed to work during hours of emergency. These rules are applicable for publicly or privately owned vessel, a vessel engaged in the voyage by sea, a vessel engaged in a commercial maritime operation, that is transport of cargo and passengers, purpose of trade. These rules are not applicable to the vessels traditional designs such as junks and dhows. Vessel of less than 500 gross registered ton, vessel engaged in a fishing operation, estuarial craft. This work rest hour, ILO MLC 2006 requirement for the work and rest hours, STCW 2010 requirement for work and rest hour, OPA 90 requirement for rest, work and rest hours. Thankfully, after Manila amendments to the STCW course, the STCW 10 requirements are made with the MLC requirement. The rest hour regulators are ILO or MLC 2006 requirements for the work rest hours, STCW 2010 requirements for work and rest hours, OPA 90 requirement for the work and rest hours. Thankfully, after the Manila amendments, the STCW and MLC requirements are made in line. This work rest hour is a requirement. As the technology improves, the people have to work less, and the authorities, administrators have found, the studies have found that seafarers are coming with a depression and fatigue and a long duration of the contract period. They found because of the lack of rest, they were finding it difficult. So they are trying to regulate the working hours on board as to make it as same as a shore. But the problem in the ship it is a limited number of people and there is no other extracurricular activities. People are confined with that. In case of an emergency, only the same people have to work, but still the work rest hour is adapted as far as possible. They are maintaining it on board.